So y'all know I'm a big fan of ClickUp. And if you don't know what ClickUp is, it's basically a project management system. And there's a ton of these out there on the market. And I've used basically every one and literally have a digital love affair with ClickUp. And I think one of the reasons, or I know one of the reasons that I have this love affair is because it has so many features and you can use the features or you cannot use the features and you're still going to have a massively awesome project management system. So in the past, I've showed you how to use ClickUp. I've showed you how to use ClickUp again when they updated it. And today I wanna talk about my personal favorite ClickUp features right now in today's time frame in 2021. Some of these are newer features, some of these are features they've had forever, but I wanna show you inside my ClickUp and some of my favorite ClickUp features. Y'all, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jessica Stansberry and I am pumped that you are here. If you're looking for a way to make a living out of living life, this is the channel for you. Before I really get into today's video, I have to say a quick thank you to today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an awesome platform where you can literally learn hashtag all the things. And I'm really pumped to tell you about them, but more about them later on in the video. So before I show you my favorite features of ClickUp, I'd love to pull back the curtain a little bit and remind you, if you didn't watch some of my first ClickUp videos, why I use ClickUp and switched to ClickUp from other platforms. So I was a big Trello user. I used Trello religiously for years. And actually, some of my most popular videos on this channel in the very beginning were about Trello. And I really, really did, and still do, kinda like Trello. But what happened was, one, as my team grew, Trello just became more of like, we were having to work around the clunkiness of the system with new team members and figuring things out in like ways that weren't natural to the system, and that felt weird. But then also there would be like little things that I would want to do that Trello just did not have the capabilities for. Now, I have no clue if they've added some of those features since I left a couple of years ago, but after hearing about ClickUp from a few different friends and people that I would consider peers in this industry, I decided to try it because I was like, oh my gosh, it's newer, but it sounds amazing. And it has literally blown my socks off from day one. Not only is the software awesome, but the team behind it is awesome. I'm always looking to use companies that are like that because yes, obviously I need a tool to do a thing, but if the company itself is actually really good, it helps me make that decision. I'm honestly not trying to sell you on ClickUp, but if you do wanna try it, I have a special discount code. All you have to do is go to heyjessica.com/ClickUp to take advantage of that. But the cool thing about ClickUp is they do have a free version and you can really try it out and figure out if you like it or not within that free version, which I love. Okay, so let's just jump into it. I'm literally going to take you into my ClickUp screen and explain to you some of my favorite features of ClickUp itself. And these are things that I felt like were missing from Trello, or at least missing from like the native version of Trello, and are some of the reasons why I switched over to ClickUp to begin with. So one of my favorite features is this Everything tab in ClickUp. So you click the Everything tab, and then you can pick what type of view you'd like to see for literally everything in your entire ClickUp space. So for me, this was one of the big reasons I switched to ClickUp over Trello, because in Trello, you basically could view a calendar view, a board view, a list view, whatever, of every different board, but there was no good way to see all the boards in one place or all the tasks in all the boards in one place. Now, again, I don't know if they've changed that since I left, because I left a few years ago, but this is something that I love about ClickUp. So once you click everything, you can literally see everything either on a list view, a board view, or a calendar view. Now, I think the list view and the board view get really confusing when you're looking at everything, but on a calendar view, oh my gosh, it makes my heart so happy because I can literally see what's going on every day inside of different projects in my business. And the really cool part that I also love, which wasn't even on this list of things for me to tell you, but I might as well, is this little toggle here that's like only show the tasks that are assigned to me. So once you do that, then I can really look at my week and say, what do I need to be doing this week? And this really helps me decide what my to-do list is every week and every day. So today, when I'm recording this, I can see some like overarching things that are happening. I can also see that I need to promote my new course that is launching today when I'm recording this on Instagram, that we have it on the calendar to remove signup ad and replace it with a signup for the program ad on the podcast. Then I can see here that I have this July workbook and worksheet content that I need to work on and have due to my assistant. So at the beginning of the week, I can go here and toggle on just me, and I can see like what needs to be done each week. So if I have like an audit that needs to be done, because I sell YouTube audits, they are listed here. If I have something I need to be working on, we generally push the date back so that I can see it in this view way before it's actually due, so I don't just miss it. So this is one of my favorite features, and being able to toggle on, you know, what I want to see and even customize even better, like show subtasks if I want to do that. I can look at this however I want to, and this is literally one of my favorite features, just being able to see everything from every piece of my ClickUp space in one place is just, oh, it makes my nerdy little heart happy. All right, another feature that I absolutely love inside of ClickUp and we use all the time for bonuses in my program, for a lot of other things, I'll kind of explain as I go, but that is forms inside of ClickUp. So ClickUp itself has a form builder. So something like Typeform or Google Forms or whatever you would use outside of ClickUp, you can actually build something like that out in ClickUp. Now I will say it doesn't have the same features as some of the features in Typeform, but to me it's worth having a little less features to know that that form goes directly where I want it to go in ClickUp, and it's really easy for us to create and share and all the things. So this form we're looking at here is for my new retail store. We basically filled up all of the vendor spots and no longer have any vendor spaces available. But what was happening is even though we were only sending the link to sign up and reserve a vendor spot to people who we had approved, somehow or another, somebody shared the link. And so we started getting like vendor applications and contracts that were people we hadn't approved and for people we just did not have room for. So we removed that. Thankfully, it was a pretty link. And we removed that form. We pointed the pretty link to this new form, which is literally just built in ClickUp. And so it has a waiting list, first and last name, email, booth or business name, a description, attaching some photos, and then they can submit. And that's it. And that way we can say, hey, we're completely full, like, sorry, but if you'll fill this out, you'll be the first one to know when we have availability. And that is an awesome thing as well. We do this a lot with my programs or when we're somebody purchases something specifically. So for instance, today, literally today, I'm launching a new course, and this course is called Course Academy, and I'm teaching you how to create and sell your first online course successfully. And a couple of the bonuses that I'm giving away today only need more information from the person who purchases outside of what the purchase form is going to collect. So there's one of the bonuses is a t-shirt. And so we need like t-shirt sizes and mailing addresses, which we don't normally collect on checkout. And then another bonus is an audit of some sort. So we'll need some information from them to be able to do that audit. So we will use the form built in ClickUp. And the really cool part about this, you can tell ClickUp like where to put those form responses. So for this one, we literally have a waiting list here that people are starting to put their name on. And so once they fill out the form, it literally goes straight to this waiting list column. So if we start like removing people from the foundry or people start leaving after their contract is up, we can go back to this waiting list and say, hey, let's go through this and let them know what we have available. Okay. So I love that. It also lets you tag people. So within the form settings itself, you can say like, when this is filled out, put it here, and then also tag this person or this person. And I love stuff like that because then I get tagged in it. It shows up on my calendar if it's got a date assigned to it, or on my list in my everything folder, and I can work through it from that angle. One of the newer features that ClickUp has that I have not personally been able to try out yet, but I'm going to very soon because I really see the possibility and opportunity in it, is email inside of ClickUp. So they just launched this, and as soon as I saw it, like I saw an ad for it on Facebook, I was like, oh my gosh. And I sent it straight to my assistant, Laura, and I was like, look at this, because it seems like it will be a really awesome thing that we can incorporate in certain areas of the business. So some of my favorite features of ClickUp are coming up next. But before I share those, this is a great place to pause and talk about today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is this crazy awesome platform that has classes upon classes upon classes to literally help you learn whatever you want to learn. So if you are a YouTuber and you want to learn video editing, or you want to start a podcast and you want to learn how to podcast, you can do that on this platform. These are really, really high quality and high value classes. Like this one from the girls behind the Almost 30 podcast, literally teaching you how to set up a home podcasting studio so you sound really good. There are a ton of classes you can take to help you learn literally whatever you want to learn. Skillshare is one of my favorite places to go and quickly learn how to do something that I may not yet know how to do, because their premium membership lets me try out classes and take the classes I want to take at any time. They were awesome enough to give me a bunch of trials to their premium membership so I could pass that off to you. So if you're one of the first 1,000 people to click the link below, you can try out Skillshare for free with their premium membership and get to learning today. Okay, another feature, and I'm actually going to use Amazon as an example, but another feature that I love is that they do have a Chrome extension that literally puts, if you'll see that little ClickUp logo there on the bottom right-hand corner, it literally puts a ClickUp logo on every website that you visit. And what happens is when you hover over it, then you have options. You can track time that you're spending in that certain thing. So if you're like, okay, I want to track the time that it takes me to create the sales page or whatever, you can do that. You can also take a screenshot. You can bookmark the page in ClickUp, or you can add notes to this page within ClickUp. So this is basically like a note-taking app as well, which is really cool. But one of my favorite things is to just create a new task. And if you click on the little ClickUp guy, you can do any of these things. So if you're on a page that you want to do something on, you can easily screenshot it, time track it, whatever. You can bookmark it and add that to an actual card in ClickUp. So if I wanted to bookmark this, let's say I'm working on my book, I'm trying to find like book covers that inspire me or something like that, and I'm on Amazon, I'm like looking through things, I can choose to bookmark it. I just choose where I want to bookmark it. So I'm going to say the book process, whatever. Love this cover idea. And then I'm just going to put test so I don't forget it. You can uncheck or check to include a screenshot, and you can click save bookmark, and then it goes into ClickUp. So there's a ton of different possibilities with this Chrome extension, but it's one of my favorite things about ClickUp because it makes it really easy to do things on the go or in processes. I have squirrel brain. So a lot of times I'll be on another website and think of something I need to put in ClickUp. So it's really easy for me to just hit create new task and put something in ClickUp without actually navigating to ClickUp. And that's really awesome as well. Automations. Okay, so this next thing was actually one of my favorite features of Trello, but it wasn't built into Trello. You had to use Butler for Trello, and then still the workarounds were sometimes really clunky and didn't work. And I was so excited when they released automations, which is what I'm talking about, in ClickUp shortly after I switched over, because it was one of the things I definitely missed in the process. But the way that I use these most is with statuses. So let's say I have my calendar pulled up for my podcast and I am wanting to record this podcast episode here, and I go in and I record it and everything's done, and I want, when I change this from open to ready to edit and write show notes, I want it to remove me and add Laura, my assistant, as the person tagged on the card so that it no longer shows up for like my tasks and now it shows up for hers, I can do that. So inside of the board, you just go to automations and we can actually see what automations I currently have. So when the status changes, change the assignee. So again, that's me, remove me, add Laura. When the task is created, change the assignee. So when I create the task of this is the podcast episode I want to create, then it assigns it to me. So when I'm looking at my weekly calendar, I can see if I've like missed something or whatever. You can literally do anything. You can actually browse automations. So if you need some inspiration on what might work best for you, you can do that. I could also, you know, when the status changed to uploaded and scheduled, which is one of my statuses, I could go ahead and close or archive the task. When the due date arrives on something, you can have something happen. It's just super fun, and it makes running a business and creating content and whatever else that I'm doing really seamless, because then it's easy for us to see everything and it does it for us half the time. Okay, the last feature I want to talk about, and this is also one of my favorites, is dashboards. So within ClickUp, you can create as many dashboards as you want to, but you can create dashboards. And these dashboards are like a bird's eye view at certain things, and you get to pick what those certain things are. So if I want to create a dashboard where I see all of my upcoming tasks, I see everything that needs to be done for YouTube and my podcast in one place, I can do that. So it's not the same as the everything board. I'm picking and choosing what goes where. You can also add chat. So if like your team is working through a launch, you could have everything for that launch in the dashboard, including a chat specifically about the launch. Super quickly, if I wanted to add a dashboard that was like top of mind, and I want to add things to it, like my task list, only things that are assigned to me within a certain due date. So I can create a task list. So my stuffs, and I can find whatever. So I want to select all. I want to group it by due date so that I can see things that maybe are due sooner than other things. I want to include subtasks. I don't care about archive tasks or close. And then I want to filter it by things that are assigned to me. So filter it by assignee, and the assignee is me. I have basically a list that's going to show up in this widget that's all the things that I need to do that might be past due. And a lot of times what shows up here is things I've just not like closed or checked off. But I can go through and easily see what's going on. So if I have this, then I can just click on it. I can go ahead and change the status to closed if I want to, and that will go away. So I could have that. I could also create, again, a chat. So if I want to name this like team chat, then I can add this widget here and I can invite people to it. So if I know this is something I want to add Laura to, I can add her to it. And then I can also like tag her here and we can create an entire filtered chat here. You can also embed like YouTube videos or Google Docs or Twitter feeds or stuff like that inside of a dashboard. So if I wanted to embed a YouTube video inside of a dashboard, because it maybe explained a process or whatever, or we're working on a project and we really need quick access to a Google Sheet or a Google Form or a Google Doc or whatever, we could embed it here, which is really cool. I hope that was super freaking helpful. If you're like me and you nerd out on project management systems, or you just really like to see what maybe you're not doing in a system, hopefully this video was really helpful for you. If you are not yet subscribed, make sure you subscribe to my channel right down below. And thank you again to today's sponsor, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. If you do want to try out Skillshare, remember that the first 1,000 of you who click the link below will get a free trial of their premium membership. And until next time, bye y'all.